your name and tell me about yourself.
Okay, so my name is Rachel. I do many things. I love photography. I'm a model. I am from London, really, kind of ish. Mm-hmm. Well, people that are far away, I'm from London, but I actually live in Guildford currently. I've just moved out. I work in a few different like hospitality industries. So I do like bar work and waitressing, and like a little bit of cleaning on the side for like big, rich, posh houses. Because, you know, I love being someone's little bitch.
love that.
I think that's kind of it. I'm very bubbly. I've got ADHD.
Yay!
Yeah, I'm very hyper and confident and friendly and just chill and down to earth, and I don't really give a shit about anything, really.
I love that. Okay. When I say the word identity, what do you think of?
Doing what you want to do and being who you want to be. Mm-hmm. Like, it's about a person as they are, like the most pure they can be. Mm-hmm. You know, like take off all like the fake shit and get down to like them, what they actually enjoy, what they're like as a person, their personality, like their values as well. I think values is a special, like that's like a serious thing, I think. It's cool how there's so many things, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
I don't know. I leave it as that.
I like that. Okay. Do you believe that individual identity has been muted by societal and political ideas, or does the classification of identities help with the evolution of individuality? Yeah.
I'm gonna think of it as the way you explained the question earlier. I forgot what I was saying. I don't understand the question.
So do you think we need stereotypes in order to evolve?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So like going back to what I explained last time, I think if 100 years ago, like people would, because being gay or being trans or like wanting to be something else that you weren't born as, mm-hmm. or what are like socially acceptable, because they weren't accepted, then, for example, if me 100 years ago, being into girls and guys and basically just being like pan or bi, or like, I don't know, I don't want to label it, you know.
100%.
But talking about labels, like I think it obviously has helped me, because when I was like 7, being like, oh, I like, why do I only have to fancy my classmates that are boys? Like, mm-hmm. I'm kind of like fancy my best mates. Like, is that normal? And finding out that there is a thing called bisexuality and a thing called homosexuality, then it's helped me to obviously understand and develop that and bring it into me as a person. But I don't need it. Like, obviously, I think without having those labels and someone saying, oh, like, I'm into girls, it'd be like, oh, that's not normal, because it's not spoken of. So having the labels has 100% like made people be able to be who they are, I think. Like, I feel like they obviously, with me, like, it's helped me 100%. Like, without them, then people would not have a clue what they're feeling, and they'd probably push it down into themselves and not let it out.
Exactly.
So
I agree with that 100%. Okay. What's the most hurtful comment you've gotten about your identity?
When I think about identity, like, obviously me, I'm very, like, outgoing and mm-hmm. I'm impulsive as fuck.
So, you're yourself. You're,
I just do what I want to do, you know? Yeah. So, like, I think when I started dressing, like, alternatively, mm-hmm. when I was probably, like, 14 or 15 or 16 or something, and I, like, you know, started wearing like boyfriend jeans to Mufti Days and like double denim, and like, you know, like got my first pair of Doc Martens, and I was just a bit more like grungy and like different to all like the basic girls in my school. Mm-hmm. Then I feel like people were like I think sometimes my family would take the piss. Like, they obviously, they like love how creative I am and like wear like what I do now, what I think. I mean, they don't really appreciate the tattoos, but you know, all the piercings, but I don't really care. Yeah. I feel like some people, yeah, took the piss out of like my fashion, but that was who I am. Like, I want to wear what I want to wear.
You're a canvas. Your body's a canvas.
And when I shaved my head, that was the biggest part, because people, like, so I shaved my head, then I went to Amsterdam, and obviously Amsterdam, everyone's fucking cool, you know, like, it's just the vibe there. But I went, like, a few times I've been clubbing in Amsterdam and in Surrey as well, so in England, like, a couple of words would be like, oh, are you actually a girl? Mm-hmm. Even after they might have like kissed me or something, you've been dancing with me, and then like half an hour later they were like, wait, so are you actually a girl, or like are you like a boy? Just because I had no hair.
Oh,
I'd
wow.
be having, you know, my boobs out and be wearing what I want to wear, you know, clubbing, and they'd have the audacity to ask me after kissing me and, you know, like putting their hands on my fucking hip and dancing me, like, oh, are you actually a girl? Like, yeah.
Mm.
I mean,
and like
that
they still found you attractive, they kissed you.
Yeah, like, I don't know, like, I don't really take shit offensively because mm-hmm. I genuinely don't care about people's opinions, really. Like, I'm just very free. Like, I don't let people get to me. But that's probably the worst, when people say like, oh, you look like a lesbian, or like, you look like a boy and stuff like that. But it's like, why does hair have to define me? Do you
right.
know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was like, I think my hair has been the biggest thing that's like bad about my identity, as well as being like quite like a loud and bubbly person. People would always be like, oh, she's annoying or something. But like, dude, I want to,
yeah.
this is me. I don't care. So yeah, I go on for ages, fuck.
It's fine, don't worry. Have you experienced discrimination?
Oh wow. A little bit, I'd say, work.
Mm-hmm.
So when I shaved my head, that wasn't allowed. Like, my mum told me to write a formal letter to ask if it was all right, and I was like, okay, it's 2020,
yeah.
like, I shouldn't have to do that, and I shouldn't have to take out any piercings for work, I shouldn't have to change the way I dress for where I'm going. Like, this is like, why society put such labels and everything, and like, oh, if you've got tattoos and a shaved head, like, you're obviously a criminal. Like, no. Like, I don't know, a bit of discrimination with that, and I guess maybe, I don't know, probably just like, the hair has been a big problem, but not really.
Mm-hmm.
It's only people that obviously care about issues and insecure, they want to take the piss out of everyone else.
Exactly.
Because they're basic and can't be creative.
Okay. What's a stereotype that's limited the self-expression of your identity?
Oh, please explain what that means.
So, is there like a typical stereotype that kind of makes you feel unable to express yourself, like, fully?
Yeah. Obviously, there's nothing wrong with being a lesbian because
yeah.
I like girls.
Yeah.
And at points, I've thought I was fully gay, but obviously, like, right now, I've got a boyfriend. Like, I've been with boys and girls. I'm just. I don't care. No label.
Yeah.
But I think at some points, the way I dress, if I dress like quite boyish, if I'm wearing like a full tracksuit because I want to be comfy and because I've got short hair, then I'm obviously a lesbian. And it's like, I feel like that's a lot of things that lots of girls will have short hair and they'll always think, oh, she's definitely gay.
Word.
It's like, well, I mean, it doesn't matter if you are, but like, you don't need to assume that.
Yeah.
You know? And like, I think that's, yeah, one thing, hair and like the way I dress. Sometimes people think I'm like gay, so I'm a classic stereotype of that. Which I'm literally not bothered about, because people that know me, or like, for example, like, I've got a boyfriend, so I don't really care if people think I'm a lesbian. If they do, I don't care, because I like girls. Girls are fucking great, and females are beautiful, so, you know. Like, but that's probably one. I'm not sure anything else. Like, I think it's mainly just like being fully gay just because I've got short hair. Yeah.
I get that. 100%. Okay. What do you like about living here in London, and how has it helped you create your identity or be yourself?
I think we're quite lucky compared to some countries that, you know, you can't, like, gay is illegal, or like being gay is wrong. Like, there's so much religion in the country that you can't be who you are. But I think with London, so many cultures are in it as well. There's so many different styles. Like, if you go to, for example, like Camden, you've got like the group of like the emos and the grunge
yeah.
people that have like Mohicans.
Yeah.
Mohicans, that's it.
Yeah.
Is that how it's said?
Mohicans, yeah.
Mohicans.
Oh, yeah.
Such a funny name. They've got that, and like, people that have like loads of piercings. I feel like there's always people, I guess, like with like me, that have like tattoos and piercings. And I feel like in London, I've been lucky because it's like quite a streetwear fashion kind of city.
Mm-hmm.
So like, when I got to London, I like to do like my full style, like full outfits. But when I'm just chilling, like, yeah, I think we're lucky because in like a stylish area.
Yeah.
I like the vibes, especially just like Camden, Brighton, Soho. Brighton's like a good place because like that's like the gay city. So like, you can literally wear whatever the fuck you want and doesn't, like, you won't get judged in Brighton. So Yeah. London's cool. I like it. Sometimes.
Sometimes.
There's some issues, but meh. Whatever.
No. I get that. And last question. In a political sense, do you think you're a floating identity or a product of the system?
What, so do I go with the system or do I... No.
Like subconsciously though. Because in a way, we, even if we think we're so free with ourselves, for some reason we always align to a category, and like, why is that?
Yeah. Like, I will always align to like the street grunge bisexual girl.
Yeah.
I want to be like, I do what I want. But yeah. Everyone says that. Everyone will be like, oh, I dress the way I want. Or like, this is how I want to be. But it's like...
You have a style.
Fashion is put into society through the stores. You buy what you want and put it together. But imagine if you could literally make your own clothes and stuff, you know? Like, imagine... I don't know, like... You... Wow, that's big question. Like, that
isn't
could,
it?
Wow.
Yeah.
I feel like... I would love to say I'm floating... Mm-hmm. I'm just like doing what I want, which most of the time I do, but obviously I am still sticking to an identity and style of identity that I
want. And there's always other people's
like,
perceptions.
Yeah, exactly. And Instagram as well. Like, I'll go onto like models' accounts and be like, oh, because like I'm a model, like I want to dress like that. Yeah. Or like, do you know what I mean? Like, I guess. Oh, mate. I don't really know what to say. I would love to be floating and different, but like you can never be completely different. You're always gonna match someone else's style or be in the same kind of like group or like as someone else. Like there's never anyone that's like completely different from everyone. Like, I mean, we're all human, you can't really get too far away from each other, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that would be great if I could be completely free. I feel like everyone would want that.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Instagram and social media has definitely played a big part in like not being able to be a free identity.
Yeah.
So, but hopefully one day, maybe I'll get there.
Yeah.
I'm trying my best.
Thank you so much, Rachel. Loving your outfit.
Thanks, girl. Oh, my knee hurts.